Hey, boys and girls, it's a brand new day and time for another exciting episode of Cancel Culture. It's over. I'm not making this up. Oxford University has decided that, well, sheet music is racist. Why? Because it's written on white paper? I mean, this is absolutely absurd and ridiculous, but this is the level of mass delusion and idiocracy that the entire planet is now suffering from. That story is actually being reported in the Daily Beast, the Daily Bugle, outlets from the UK, as well as Fox News Online. That said, the earth-shattering news yesterday that Captain Underpants, something I know absolutely nothing about, other than I wear underwear, they're canceling a couple of their books where they were insensitive to Asian Americans in depicting them as senseis and masters of karate and kung fu. Okay. Every day, something else is being canceled. Now, there are certain things that, personally, I would like to see canceled. This is Dr. Richard, they want to be called Rachel Levin, the new Assistant Director of Health for the United States, the first openly transgendered individual to serve in a presidential administration.
I'm the Tooth Fairy.
Man, dig that crazy chick.
Not a chick. There's a word that rhymes with that, but I can't say it because I'm a pastor. This is a dude. And this type of idiocy is what needs to be canceled. You know, they tell us to follow the science. Well, it's a simple scientific method. You either have an XY chromosome or you don't. You're either a boy or you're a girl. It's really, really that simple. And to try to continue to flip everything, what used to be up is now down, what used to be down is now up, hot is now cold, cold is now hot. To keep doing all of this confusion and delusion and this inside out, upside down, backwards, dyslexic is now the understanding and language of the era. This is what needs to be canceled. Consider this. The iconic Volkswagen Beetle, which really exploded on the American auto scene in the early 1960s. We so fell in love with this little car, we even made a movie franchise out of it, Herbie the Love Bug. And 50 plus years later, the bug, the Beetle, the punch buggy, is still popular. People still buy them. But are you aware of its origins? If we're going to cancel sheet music because white European guys back in the day were the ones that wrote the original symphonies, operas, etc., we're going to cancel Mr. Potato Head. We're going to cancel Dr. Seuss books because there's some implied racism maybe from 60 plus years ago. Why are we not canceling the Volkswagen, one of the preferred vehicles of our liberal friends? Why does the Volkswagen get to stay? You do know where it came from, right? Nazi Germany. That's right. Volkswagen, the people's car, developed under the Nazi regime with direct supervision by the one and only Adolf Hitler himself. Here he is viewing the brand new car to roll off the assembly line. I believe this is 1937. Taking a ride in the back seat. Funny how Volkswagen never mentions Hitler in any of their current ads, isn't it? You know, on the one hand, we could say that Hitler wasn't such a bad guy. Look, he came up with the Volkswagen. In fact, Laffin back in the day used to do a sketch of that, where a guy as Hitler would stick his head out one of the little doors and say, "Everybody hated me, but nobody ever sent me for the Volkswagen." Why are we not canceling the Volkswagen? It obviously is tied to Hitler, which means it's an anti-Semitic car. No, the car is not anti-Semitic. You know, there are still some people with some functioning brain cells intact, some rational thought intact. And so we don't cancel the car because Hitler was the president and he oversaw its production and he wanted a cheap car for the masses. And we know the horrible things that the Nazi regime did. But it's funny, we've kept the car. We haven't canceled it. Yet people who said things maybe 15, 20 years ago when they were kids themselves are now being canceled. They're losing jobs. They're losing their livelihoods. They're losing their reputations. They're losing their futures. This is the insanity that we have sunk into. And now you even have people coming out and they're canceling themselves for anything that they might have said, thought, or doodled on a sheet of paper that if anybody were to find out, I can't believe I said that. Stop. Stop the cancel insanity. Just a quick rant. Hope you liked it. Give us a thumbs up and a big like. Make sure you're a subscriber to the channel. Smack the bell. Click the word all to get notification of all of my rants.